Hello and welcome to another video in this TI Precision Lab series on magnetic position sensing. My name is Manny Soltero. Hall effect switches and latches enable simple, compact, reliable, and cost-effective solutions for contactless motion sensing. These devices are rapidly gaining popularity in a wide array of electromechanical systems for detecting changes in physical quantities such as distance, angle, pressure, fluid level, flow rate, etc. In this video, we cover the underlying properties that explain similarities and differences between Hall effect switches and latches, as well as design procedures that simplify their integration into typical applications. We start with an overview of the basic concepts. Hall effect switches and latches are a class of Hall effect magnetic sensors that convert a magnetic flux density signal, commonly known as the B field, to a 1-bit digital output. These devices are typically used with permanent magnets to enable contactless motion sensing applications. Hall effect switches and latches are directional and sense the B field components along their axes of sensitivity. Most have a single axis of sensitivity, although some specialized devices may have up to 3 axes of sensitivity. Hall effect switches and latches sense different attributes of the applied B field. Switches sense amplitude, whereas latches sense polarity. Polarity is said to be positive when the flux lines are in the direction of the axis of sensitivity. Otherwise, polarity is said to be negative. From a behavioral standpoint, Hall effect switches and latches are essentially magnetic comparators with hysteresis. The upper switching threshold, BOP, is called the operate point, and the lower switching threshold, BRP, is called the release point. The absolute difference between the thresholds is the hysteresis of the comparator. Hysteresis represents the amount by which the input must change in the opposite direction relative to a threshold to cause the output state to change. Switches and latches have similar responses to the incident magnetic field. The output voltage is low when the input amplitude exceeds BOP, and high when the input amplitude is less than BRP. The difference in behavior between switches and latches is due to the polarity of their magnetic thresholds. Switches have BOP and BRP of the same polarity to be able to detect changes in B field amplitude, even if polarity remains the same. On the other hand, latches have BOP and BRP of opposite polarity to be able to detect changes in B field polarity, as long as the B field amplitude is large enough. We now turn to typical applications. Hall effect switches are predominantly used for proximity sensing as they are sensitive to B field amplitude. In the typical case, a permanent magnet moves along the sensor's axis of sensitivity in either direction. The design requires selecting a sensor and magnet such that the sensor output toggles when the magnet is at specified distances, D1 and D2, from the sensor. Sensor selection is driven by a simple first-order analysis based largely on the observation that B field amplitude at the sensor location varies approximately as the inverse square of the distance from the magnet. The analysis generates equation 2, which establishes the sensor selection criterion. Here's an example illustrating the application of the sensor selection criterion to the DRV5032 family of Hall effect switches. Given that the switching distances are D1 equal 2 mm and D2 equal 6 mm, it is expected that a sensor with BOP max divided by BRP min less than 9 would be suitable. Computing the ratio of switching thresholds for all existing DRV5032 variants It is seen that only the DRB5032 DU, AJ, and ZE versions meet the sensor selection criteria. This means that it is possible to select a magnet that will cause the outputs of these devices to toggle at the required switching distances. With sensor selection completed, a suitable magnet must now be selected. Magnet selection requires a few iterations. The selection process is simplified greatly by our online magnetic field calculator. The calculator takes magnet geometry and material type as inputs and calculates the B field amplitude in millitesla at various distances from the magnet's north-south axis. Assuming the DRB5032AJ is selected for this application, we adjust the magnet properties until the B field amplitude at 2 mm exceeds a BOP max of 9.5 millitesla, and the B field amplitude at 6 mm is less than a BRP min of 3 millitesla. Clearly, a cylindrical ferrite magnet with approximately 1.7 millimeter diameter by 1.7 millimeter thickness meets the required switching distances for the DRB5032DU as well as the AJ version. Hall effect latch sensors are predominantly used for encoding rotary and other types of periodic motion. Incremental rotary encoding is used to resolve changes in the angle of a rotating shaft. A magnet fixed to the rotating shaft converts angle information into a rotating magnetic field, which changes polarity and magnitude as it rotates. A latch sensor placed near the rotating magnet converts the field polarity changes to a pulse train. Thus, the change in angle can be estimated by counting the number of edges in the pulse train. Resolution can be improved by increasing the number of polarity changes per 360-degree cycle. This is achieved by increasing the number of magnetic poles. Increasing the number of sensors also improves resolution. Using two or more sensors provides the additional benefit of resolving the direction of rotation. The proximity of a magnet to the sensor is not critical as long as flux density amplitude to the sensor location exceeds the sensor's BOP max specification. Equations 3A, 3B, and 4 can be used to select the important design parameters. We can now look at an example where the design calls for a target angle resolution of 5 degrees and a 10,000 RPM maximum angular velocity. The goal is to select the number of poles, the number of latch sensors, and the required sensor sampling rate. Applying equation 3A reveals that at least 72 transitions are required in all to achieve a 5 degree minimum angle resolution. If we use two sensors to support shaft direction, then the magnet must have at least 36 poles or 18 pole pairs. However, if only a 20 pole magnet is available, then the number of sensors must be increased to achieve the target resolution. Solving equation 3A for M indicates that a minimum of 4 latch sensors are needed with a 20 pole magnet. The required sampling rate can be calculated directly from equation 4 and is satisfied by a number of devices including the DRV5011, DRV1513, and DRV5015. To find more magnetic position sensing technical resources and search products, visit ti.com/halleffect.